The election just weeks away. We're checking in with people across southern Colorado, getting their feedback as we get closer to election day. And tonight, we're hearing from Pueblo educators and how the union presence plays a role in Steel City politics. News 5's Allison Zimmerman reports.
With the union presence in Pueblo, it's become an important part in the grand scheme of the state's politics, and it's one of the reasons professionals like teachers feel the community has their back, something they're looking for in elected leaders come November.
Pueblo is a union town. It is a blue-collar working-class town.
You don't have to look hard in Pueblo to find its union presence.
Labor is an important movement in America's history and in Pueblo's history.
With a rich manufacturing history in the steel industry, unions here are considered a big part of Pueblo's political identity. Part of that was noticeable in 2018 when teachers in Pueblo's District 60 went on strike. Teachers like Kendra Zerfus served on the bargaining team during the strike.
I think that is unique. I mean, it just doesn't happen like that in any other place in the state.
An elementary art teacher says the union presence made a big difference as teachers found themselves on the picket lines.
Well, and I do think that's why Pueblo is strong in that regard, because we do partner with other unions and it's not like you're out by yourself.
The teachers are a proud, proud members of that tradition.
All of this plays a bigger role in the grand scheme of Pueblo politics. The union presence is considered part of the reason Pueblo is known as a more Democrat-leaning county in the state. In 2016, the county turned red by a small margin for Donald Trump. In 2018, the county blew again for Governor Polis, making Pueblo a pivot county in 2020.
And that's sort of the unwritten rule of American society, is we strive to give our kids better than what we had.
For many educators in Pueblo, it's concerns over funding at the forefront of this election.
I'm just looking for those who understand that if we want to make positive changes in our communities, it starts here. It starts in the school building.
Everybody's looking for that silver bullet, and there really isn't one. There is never going to be the silver bullet, but we've got to be able to fix some of the problems that we've got.
Add on to the challenges already facing educators, this year the pandemic has added another layer for many of them. All considerations teachers are looking at ahead of November.
Of course, unions and the education community in Pueblo is just one part of Pueblo politics. In the coming weeks, we'll be taking a look at the state as a whole and hear from people on what they're looking for this year's election. Always watching out for you, Southern Colorado, Allison Zimmerman, News 5.